Well, speaking of assembly elections, Bengal, remember, is going to be a big target for the BJP in 2021. And the big breaking news coming in at the moment, very interesting. Mamata Banerjee, West Bengal Chief Minister, will attend Narendra Modi's swearing-in ceremony on Thursday. Mamata, we are told, is to reach the national capital tomorrow. Mr. Modi has sent invitations to all the chief ministers across the country. So the big story coming in at the moment, Mamata Banerjee is reaching Delhi tomorrow. And she's expected to meet the Prime Minister or certainly attend his swearing-in ceremony. Listen in to what Mamata Banerjee said a short while ago. So after that bitter and polarized campaign in Bengal, is this a gesture of reconciliation by Mamata Banerjee? Let's go straight across to Manogya Loigwal. She joins me at the moment from Kolkata. Manogya, how are you seeing this decision of Mamata Banerjee? What is the politics behind Mamata's decision to attend this swearing-in ceremony?
Never say never. That's the word and the phrase that has always been used in politics, but is being used more often in West Bengal now. The second phrase I would put it and sum it up would be exactly stating that change is the only constant. For all the high drama that you saw, the high voltage and diplomatic drama across the state of West Bengal, 42 Lok Sabha seats, out of which 18 have now been won by BJP, and the rest with TMC, besides two with Congress. This, of course, is expected, and this comes on a day when Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee and also TMC Supremo knows that she's lost her very important lieutenants across the state, not just about the councillors. And even as we speak, Rajdeep, there are certain joinings happening in North Bengal in the local political party offices of BJP in Siliguri. That itself gives you an idea on the sweep that the BJP has had. But the politics behind this is, of course, that she knows that there is a rival and there is a trust and there is a respect that she would give to the rival for the constitutional post that she holds and the constitutional invite that she's got as the chief minister of the state of West Bengal. Now, this is also important where she's mentioned clearly that she's spoken to other chief ministers. No mention, no points for guessing on who those chief ministers are. Non-BJP chief ministers, and will be attending the swearing-in ceremony of Prime Minister in Delhi. But most importantly, with Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee flying down to Delhi, this itself could be a well-new chapter and would be interesting to watch on whether the Prime Minister and Chief Minister of West Bengal shake hands if they meet at all.
I'm certain they will shake hands almost, but with Mamata Banerjee, she's an astute politician. Clearly, there is a political agenda in reaching out at this stage to Prime Minister Modi. Manogya Loigwal there joining me from Kolkata. Now, all of this comes 1 month after the Prime Minister's warning, in a sense, to Mamata Banerjee. Remember, during the campaign, the Prime Minister claimed that there were more than 40 TMC MLAs ready to switch over. Well, two of them and 50 councillors officially jumped ship today and joined the BJP. Leading them, or leading the shift away, is a one-time Mamata aide, Mukul Roy, now with the BJP, who seems to be determined to take on his one-time Didi.
The stunning election setbacks and BJP's phenomenal rise in West Bengal are making Mamata Banerjee's brigade nervous and restless. In a major blow to the Trinamool Congress, two of its MLAs and several councillors jumped ship to join the BJP on Tuesday. One of them is BJP leader Mukul Roy's son, who was suspended by Mamata for 6 years over his anti-party comments. Along with the TMC leaders, one CPM MLA has also joined the BJP. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, during election campaigning, had claimed 40 TMC MLAs are in touch with his party.
It is the desire of the Bengal. People are unhappy with the Mamtas. In the last Panchayat Chunav, our 80 people were killed. Bengal is now is a Lutaraka government. So it's against me Bangla ka rai hai.
Meanwhile in Bengal, violence continued unabated. In B room, miscreants targeted a BJP victory rally and hurled bombs. In Durgapur, alleged BJP workers targeted a TMC office and ransacked the building. And in Natabari, Bengal Minister Rabindranath Ghosh faced protests when he visited his constituency to retake TMC offices taken over by the BJP.
The fissures are now expected and are now cracking up Trinamool Congress one after the other. This is just the beginning with BJP taking a lead with one municipality after the other. But what in terms of BJP themselves, picture abhi baki hai mere dost. With Bureau Input from Delhi, this is Manogya Loiwal in Kolkata for India Today.
So let's go across to someone who rarely speaks but is the person who in a sense is behind the revolt in the Trinamool Congress now with the BJP. One time Mamata aide Mukul Roy joining me. Mukul da, what are you up to? You know, in an interview a few days ago, you said more than 140 BJP Trinamool MLAs are ready to switch sides. Is that what you are planning, to break the Trinamool Congress before the 2021 elections, or will you wait for the Bengal election before you make your move?
It is up to the peoples of Bengal. Bengal election is due on 2021. There is no plan for BJP to topple the BJP Trinamool government. But one thing, it is very clear, if the MLAs of the Trinamool Congress left their party and Trinamool lose his number, then there will be the question.
No, my point to you is, are you in a sense, today two MLAs have defected, including your son. What is your plan? What are you trying to do? Are you trying to slowly encourage people to leave Mamata Banerjee? Are you alluring them by offering them some posts? Is it about cash, or are they leaving on their own?
No, question does not. We will encourage that Bengal has lost his past glory. Mm-hmm. Last eight years, mm-hmm. Bengal has lost their glory that has been lost. After 35 years, mm-hmm. with high hope, Bengal people wants to see that there will be a radical change in the Bengal, but nothing has been happened. No industry, no education, no employment, mm-hmm. nothing else. Even the culture, creed of the Bengals. What we have seen, that a chief minister of a federal structure, chief minister of a state, in an election campaigning meeting, stated that she will ready to give a thappor to the prime minister of the country. This is not the culture of Bengal. So in last 8 years, mm-hmm. Bengal lost its culture and in democracy.
You know, it's very interesting. Very interesting, Mukul da, you are saying that. Sorry to intervene.
Mamata has assured.
No. Very interesting. You are saying this today, but you are Mamata's closest aide. Suddenly, you are saying that she has destroyed Bengal's culture. Isn't it very convenient now that you have shifted to BJP that you are targeting her?
It is objectionable. Hmm. You are not saying one time Mamata was very close to Rajiv. Mamata was very close to Congress. He left the Congress, now his position that Mamata is TMC. I was at one time was close to Mamata, but at that present moment I am in BJP. So this is the identity. You cannot say one time you are close to that. Mamata was very close to Rajiv Gandhi at one time.
Mm-hmm. But Mukulda, what is it that you are offering these MLAs at the moment? What are you offering them to switch over? Why are they? Is it true that these repeated allegations are being made, that you all are giving them some kind of loaves and fishes of office to ask them to switch over, or are they doing it voluntarily? Are they doing it on their own?
They are doing it. First of all, Mamata should answer they have put the post of opposition of PAC, Public Accounts Committee, to his district president, Nodia Shankar Singh. It is horse trading. Manoj Bhuya, when he was Congress MLA, he was offered and give the Rajya Sabha ticket and join Trinamool Congress with a false fictitious case. It is a horse trading. Arindam, MLA of Sardipur, he has joined with Mamata. It is horse trading. Bishwanath Parial, MLA of Durgapur, joined with Trinamool Congress. Is it horse trading?
What have you been offered? Is it true that Amit Shah, Mukul Roy, when you changed sides, true that Amit Shah offered you immunity in the Narda Sarda scams? Is that the reason why you joined, or were you, is it about Mamata Banerjee, or were you seeing benefits in joining the BJP? That's what I'm asking you.
Again, I repeat, in Sarda scam, my name was not there. My name was not in the FIR. No charge sheet was filed against me. So I am denying the all bogus talks like this, that I have been involved in Sarda scam, and that's why I have joined in the BJP. This is a bogus word.
So why did you?
That at Delo, when Mamata meet with Sudipton, I leave the Trinamool Congress. That's because why Mamata left Congress?
You tell me today. Are you confident? Are you really confident of defeating Mamata Banerjee? Don't you need a local face in Bengal to defeat her in the assembly elections? Yes, you have given her a bloody nose in the Lok Sabha, but she still got more seats than you.
Question does not arise. In 294 seats, they have lost 144, 29 to Congress, 29 plus 231 to Congress, and 124 seats in favor of Bharatiya Janata Party. And another 30 seats where the margin is very lower, in the lower side, that is within 1,000 to 3,000. That is another 30 seats. We are confident that in the next assembly election, Trinamool Congress will not get the mark for getting opposition leadership.
You are saying that you will defeat Trinamool Congress. How do you explain, Mukul Roy? We are just hearing news that Mamata Banerjee is coming for the Prime Minister's swearing in. Do you see Mamata? Yes, do you see possibilities?
It is a federal structure, and this decision, it should be taken earlier, in earlier election, when Narendra Modi was elected as a Prime Minister in 2014. At that time, she was also invited, but that time she does not feel fit and proper as a federal structure to join. But thanks God, at this time, she thinks that it is federal structure, she should join.
My final question to you, Mukul Roida, is that, is it true that you know everything about Mamata Banerjee, how she functions, how her organization functions? You are the insider who has become the outsider. So you are telling the BJP how to defeat Mamata Banerjee. You are the person who knows how to defeat Mamata Banerjee because the entire inner organization of TMC is known to you. Is that true or not?
You should recollect that at the floor of parliament 2 months back, when I meet with you and Prabhuji, I have told that in this time we will get more than 19 to 21, 22 seats. At that time you are not believing, but it becomes true right now.
That is true. Clearly you have found a way. Clearly you know what is Mamata, you know how to take on Mamata Banerjee. I still will ask you, who is going to be your face? Do you have a face for Bengal? Does the BJP have a face for Bengal? Because the accusation is you all are playing Hindu-Muslim politics. The accusation against the BJP is that you are playing Hindu-Muslim politics in Bengal. You are creating a Hindu vote bank.
The question, it is not the question of Hindu-Muslim. Modi ji, in his statement, in his speech, when he was elected, that there will be no caste creed. And they doesn't believe in pseudo-secularism. It is very clear. So we are not playing the cards of Hindu and Muslim. We are in the front row, and we are going for the development. We are going for the Bengal development. In comparison with other state, Bengal is going down day by day. So we will, Bengal peoples are now think that they should be with a national political party under the leadership of Narendra Modi and Amit Ji, and Bengal will develop in future.
Mukul Roy, as I said, you rarely speak. I appreciate your joining us, giving us what is your perspective for Bengal. Next time I meet you in parliament and you claim you are going to win an election, I will take you much more seriously. I will not suggest that maybe you are dreaming. Clearly, you had a plan in mind and you've done remarkably well in this election. Thank you very much for joining me. Mukul Roy, now with the BJP, earlier with the Trinamool Congress.
And thank you for very much. Thank you.
Okay, let's then turn to the other story that's coming in. It's coming from Karnataka after a day after an editor of a Kannada daily, Vishwavani, published an article on Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy's son, Nikhil, claiming that Nikhil had targeted his grandfather, Devagowda, after a poll defeat. The Bengaluru police filed an FIR against the editor for publishing the alleged derogatory article. It's being seen as an example of autocratic tendencies within the Janata Dal secular Congress government in Karnataka. Nolan Pinto reports.
The Kumaraswamy government cracking down on free speech, choosing to target the editor of Kannada Daily, Vishwavani, for daring to publish an article on CM Kumaraswamy. Vishweshwar Bhatt had published a source-based article which claimed Nikhil had gone on a rampage in a Mysuru five-star hotel after his loss from Mandya Lok Sabha seat. The article claimed that Nikhil had abused his grandfather H.D. Devagowda, blaming him and JDS for his disastrous poll debut.
Actually, it is not an article. It is a news story, and it is not an opinionated piece. It is a news story based on the sources. Our reporter checked up with his sources. Then I published this story.
While Chief Minister Kumaraswamy rubbished the report, the ruling JDS promptly filed a police complaint. The cops booked the journalist for defamation, intentional insult, criminal intimidation, cheating, criminal breach of trust and forgery.
So this 506, so it attracts this assaulting.
Assault, yes.
I never indulged in assaulting Nikhil Kumaraswamy or Kumaraswamy.
Okay.
And 468, so that is forgery.
Okay.
And it attracts 7 years of imprisonment. And it is non-bailable in nature. So it clearly proves that their intention is they want to arrest me.
The crackdown against press did not go down well. The BJP claimed that there is an informal emergency in Karnataka.
I will demand immediately must withdraw that FIR. If not, we will take it up this issue, because they can't play with media persons. He may be not happy with media, but speaking all this nonsense, taking action against media peoples, nobody will appreciate it.
Nikhil lost to late Kannada superstar Ambarish's wife, Sumalata, who contested as an independent by a margin of over 1,25,000 votes. Is his CM father losing the free speech test now? With Nolan Pinto, Bureau Report, India Today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.